PsychYogi.org. Daly and Wilson, 2001, Risk-Taking, Intrasexual Competition and Homicide. Background. This is the third study we'll be looking at, from biology, turning to crime, and it is further categorised into gender. Daly and Wilson's study focuses on the gender differences in criminal behaviour. Typically, there is an 80-20 split between males and females who are convicted of committing crimes. So for every 10 people who are convicted of crimes, 8 of them will be men and 2 of them will be female. There are many explanations offered for this unequal gender divide in crime, including evolutionary explanations and social explanations. The study took place in Chicago, which has around 77 different areas, all of which have varying levels of social and economic prosperity. Aim. The research aimed to study and understand if there were any correlations between homicide rates and local life expectancy in Chicago. Design. The research was a correlational study which made use of several sources of information, including local demographic records, survey data from police records, school records. Daly and Wilson studied Chicago's local neighborhoods where males had a lower than average life expectancy, varying from 53.4 years to 77.4 years. The researchers then used the data they collected to plot correlations results. There were strong negative correlations found between the males' life expectancies and the differing neighborhoods' homicide rates. The greater the absenteeism from school in the specific neighborhoods, the lower the life expectancy. Similarly, the greater the truancy rates in specific neighborhoods, the lower the life expectancy. Conclusions. Daly and Wilson thought it might be possible that men in the less affluent neighborhoods may expect to live shorter lives and therefore take greater risks. Daly and Wilson partly blamed the parents, claiming that parents expect to live shorter lives themselves and therefore don't want to invest in their children and make sure they attend school. The researchers further add that an additional explanation of the findings could be to do with the varying levels of social and economic prosperity. They claim that those at the lower end of the scale believe they have nothing or less to lose, so they are more likely to be involved in risk-taking. This is just a very short evaluation for this study. Make sure to evaluate the study yourself to get a deeper understanding of it. One of the biggest problems with the study is the lack of qualitative data. The researchers have had to infer the conclusions. But one good point is that the study did collect a lot of quantitative data, which makes it easy to analyse and compare. The study was also very ethical, as it only looks at records, it didn't manipulate any variables. A weakness with the generalisability of the sample is that it's an ethnocentric sample. It focused only on Chicago, and we don't know if the results and conclusions will be generalisable to other areas. So will it be generalisable to Australia? Maybe not. We don't know, because the sample is so small. Another weakness is the methodology. The researchers used correlations, which are useful in identifying patterns, but the main problem is they can't give us causal relationship. They cannot establish cause and effect. If you've enjoyed this PsychYogi presentation, why not subscribe to keep up with all the latest videos.